Hello friends. Afghanistan remains a very hot topic across the world because the peace talks have not yielded the expected results. It also overshadows a lot of good developments that happened between Pakistan and Afghanistan, and both sides are struggling to come to terms with the new realities which are different from as they were in the mid-1990s when the Taliban seized power. As Pakistani officials say, it's a different Pakistan, not Pakistan of 1990s, and Afghanistan is also not the country that it was in 1990s. And both sides are trying to overcome the past and chart a common path for a better future. We're very happy to have with us Ambassador Omar Daoudzai, who had been ambassador to Pakistan, ambassador to Iran, and who is currently acting as a special envoy to President Ashraf Ghani for Pakistan. He's with us here, and I would like to welcome him. Daoudzai Saab, thank you very much for sparing this time. There's a basic question about trust. After all these long years and so many rounds of talks, the basic question is, why should both countries now trust each other? Why is it important?
Thank you very much. I think not trusting was wrong. The deep mistrust was wrong. That was not the right thing between the two neighboring countries that has a lot in common. The two has shared history, shared language, shared gene, from many different, shared religion. From various respects, it's two countries that must have a lot of trust between them. Circumstances pushed them to conditions that they began to mistrust each other. Now, in the past 6 months, things are gradually changing. We are gradually noticing that Pakistan is more than ever before willing to contribute and to fulfill their duty to bring the war into an end. Now, to have that from Pakistan, there should be a level of trust between the two, which was not there, and we started building it. We started building it people to people, like I said, liberal visa policy, most liberal visa policy. 5,000 Afghans get visa per day, and they cross over to Pakistan. Here, they're treated very differently from the past. In the past, they were harassed by police, they were mistreated by authorities. All of that is a thing of the past. The same is happening with Pakistani nationals that are going there. So we're building people-to-people trust. At the same time, for businessmen, there's a lot of trade going on between Afghanistan and Pakistan. That's also affecting the level of trust. Out of the 21 issues that Afghan traders had identified that they have in trading with Pakistan and through Pakistan. And now I'm reported that within the 6 months we have worked hard, none of those 21 issues exist. They all resolved. So we are looking for future, how to enhance the volume of trade between and through the two countries, and how to find new ways of trading, how to digitalize the trading system, because it's still the old system. All these are trust building between people. That leads us to the real issue, which is war in Afghanistan, because the two countries may never prosper if there is war in Afghanistan. And this is what increasingly Pakistan is realizing. Up to 2-3 years ago, the volume of trade between Afghanistan and Pakistan was about $3 billion. That dropped to $1.2 billion, or in some accounts, even to $0.8 billion. Again, it's picking up. With the trust we are building, it's picking up again. So I think the trust is going up. And there are increasingly encouraging signs that Pakistan is willing to fulfill their role, their responsibility in bringing a permanent end to the Afghan war.
Ambassador, can you tell us what are the expectations from Pakistan as far as Afghanistan's peace process is concerned? Has Pakistan delivered, and what else can Pakistan deliver?
So when Prime Minister Imran Khan visited Kabul in November 2020, which was a historic visit. There was extensive heart-to-heart talks. We put all the issues and complaints on table so that we sorted out in one day. No more complaints, no more blaming each other. The conclusion, Prime Minister Imran Khan's words were that we are willing to do our duty to the extent that you can't even think about it. But you please guide us, you Afghan brothers, you tell us what you expect. So since then, we have been very clear on our expectations. And so far, things are moving in the positive direction. For instance, if you and I were meeting a week ago, then I would have said, we are expecting Pakistan to encourage Taliban to come to negotiating table. Now Taliban are back already to the negotiating table. So now we have changed the wording. We say, let's make sure that they are consistent. They don't walk away again. And they continue with a meaningful dialogue. At the same time, war is going on in Afghanistan.
Ambassador, one question is about the war economy, the way it has evolved. There are several stakeholders in this economy, spoilers, so to say. So how do we deal with the spoilers, the stakeholders in the war economy?
Yes, that's a very important issue. Within the Taliban, there are people who have got very rich from illegitimate resources, like illegitimate taxes from mining, taxation, extra taxation, whatever. Now they might be worried about the future of their assets. We have thought about it, how to bring them to the mainfall economy. I'm not saying we have control over managing the spoilers. It's a very difficult issue. It's a very critical issue, but we are aware of it, and we would have, inshallah, ways and means to control that.
Well, thank you very much. It was a very candid talk, Ambassador Omar Daoudzai. Friends, you heard what the ambassador had to tell us. Now let's see how Afghanistan's peace process and the Doha talks pan out. Thank you very much.